Anyway, my mother taught the fourth grade boys Sunday school class. As you know, she was always partial to boys. And she thought by about that time that children should know enough that they're at the age of accountability, that they're accountable for what they were. Although, you know, there's some dispute about that being early. Anyway, she led me through the scriptures to to accept Christ as my Savior.
This is your mom.
And this was in 1941, just prior to Pearl Harbor.
Okay.
And I was baptized in the First Baptist Church, Searcy, Arkansas, on a cold winter night in December, sometime right before my fourth birthday.
Your fourth birthday? That'd be your ninth birthday.
Ninth birthday. And because, you know, some say that that's a rather young age, but I accepted Christ as a 9-year-old.
Mm-hmm.
Whether, you know, sometimes you don't have, you know, 100% understanding.
Right.
But you have enough understanding to know,
right,
that you're accountable for your sins, and that God has a plan for your life and for your whatever's before you.
Right.
And now that's been more than 70 years ago.
So he's been faithful all that time?
Yes. Mm-hmm. That's actually, God has been faithful to me. And I can see throughout my life that He's had His hand on me, and that there are different purposes for your that you can see in retrospect that you can't see otherwise. And I think that what I have to look back on, it's not my accomplishments, but what God has been able to accomplish through me by making my life available and to the family,
mm-hmm,
and to you girls, that each one of you was led to Christ about the same way, probably by your mother. But anyway, that was something that I'm proud of for them, but I know that it's God that does the work. And in looking back over my 85 years, I can see that He's had other purposes too. And that not only can it be in the family that you have, that you've raised, that's under you, but also you have others that you come in contact with. And then in losing Shirley, it was quite a blow. But I know that she really did the job needed to be done to be sure that we had Christian children and grandchildren. But when she was gone, I had an emptiness, and I sought about to find something to fill the emptiness. But I found something different. I found someone who I thought was a Christian, but found out wasn't. What she really needed was being brought to Jesus Christ as her Savior.
Yes.
And that happened through the helpfulness of Kay Russell of Newport, Arkansas, and a miraculous time that we had together. This was a life that needed to be rescued, that was quite worthy, really worthy, and has a sweet spirit that we all need. And I love Gloria and always will, in a special way. She's brought a real joy to my life.
Awesome.